on looking good every time. Jump up and wine and buck out. Not even one time can turn you out.
You got to
move up your money and dance all about.
Ladies and gentlemen, Babushka!
Babushka. This is my friend Silence. Everybody, let me hear you say hello to Silence.
Hello, Silence.
Yes, she's the only woman I trust. Now, I know you were expecting to see the show with that Hazel right away, eh? Forget it. Hazel's not coming. We tie her up in the back. It's my show tonight, me, Babushka. And I have a few important things to tell you. You know, I was away for a while. Did you miss me?
Yes.
I didn't hear you.
Oh, yes.
Yes. I was in Switzerland getting rid of a few things. Now I feel completely whole. I have one too. Oh. Oh. So, right, Silence. Poor Silence. You know, Silence and I go back a long way. I knew her when she had a body. Yes, we're still trying to find out who would run off with a girl's body. And would you believe she never said a word? But she tells me she doesn't mind just giving head. Oh, oh, you like this, you're naughty. Well, enough about me and Silence. Time for the show. So we want you to sit back, relax. Forget that shit. Bullshit. Sit up. Be tense. Confused. Pull your hair out. Ask yourself, what is this shit? Tell them you want your money back. Scream, go wild. Ay, I like that. Mwah. I see you. Come, Silence, let's go. Alone. Leave my bags alone. I don't have no mangoes in there. Thank you, Jesus, I finally reach. Take a long, long time, but honey, I finally reach. This is America, New York, where they say plenty, plenty money grow on trees. Look at all the white people. Hello. Hello. Look at all the white people with them children. They will be needing babysitters, and I am ready for them. No work is too hard for me, honey. The Empire State Building, the Statue of Liberty. God bless this America, the land of the rich and the free. You know, I don't know why in New York all those damn nasty people want to live on the street. You're too damn nasty. Get up from there. You're smelling like pee. Move, move. Honey, I'm not going to stop till I make it to the top. I'm going to get a job. Maybe two, maybe three. You know, I'm so glad I get to leave that poor hurricane little country. I just missed the tornado. But I must make it fast because my family is depending on me. I want everybody, everybody, everybody to come to America and be free. God bless this America. It is a savior for me. Taxi! Taxi! Wait. I wasn't going to tell all of this, but I'm going to talk it. When I did get off the plane, the policeman come with a damn dog to smell me up. The dog was sniffing me up all under my dress. Then they take me in some little room and start to feel up my person. I start to feel guilty. I almost give them the two mangoes I was hiding in. But I didn't want them export me. I just close my eyes and pray. They tell me they're looking for contraband. What the hell I doing with contraband? All the white women and them coming through with their hair in braids. Yes, honey, when they come down to the island on vacation, they like to braid their hair and run around with the Rasta men and them. We call it rent a dread. Nobody ever stopped them for contraband. They come to harass me. I tell you, that thing give me such a bad feeling about the place. But I tell myself I'm not gonna let them break my spirit. No. I'm not gonna let them stop me before I start. I come here to make it to the top. And that is where I'm going. To the top, top, top. Taxi! You know, where I come from, the taxi does have 2, 3, and 4 people. But look, in America, a big taxi waiting just for me. Taxi! Taxi! But like the blasted taxi man don't want to stop for me. Damn crazy! I gonna see all you. The next time all you see me, I gonna be at the top. Even if I have to walk. Because that is where I come here to go. To the top, top, top. All you take care, take care. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Put this one right here like this. Oh, girl, you looking for... Child, that's it. That's it right there. I like how that piece falls right in your eye. What? What y'all looking at? You know, a lot of people be giving me grief about my hair. Talking about I should wear my hair natural. Cause they all into this Afrocentricity with they nappy dreadlocks and shit. And I'm not having it, okay? I am into a commercial look. Cause when I look at the videos, the commercials, and the billboards, who be getting the man? I don't see none of those nappy-headed girls getting the man. Naps is cute, but that is not my feeling. I like my hair long, very long. And I'm very thankful to all of my Korean sisters who chop off their hair so that I could have it. How y'all doing? But you know, it's a lot of stuff happening with me. I can't tell y'all everything. I can only tell you a few things because I'm still trying to figure a lot of it out myself. But it's a man thing. I mean, I am waiting to exhale. You know what I'm saying? I feel like Terry told my story. I am desperate. This guy called my house the other day. It was the wrong number, but I went out with him anyway. And I want me a man that's gonna take me to fancy restaurants, okay? I am tired of going out with all of these cheap brothers, and they be trying to change your diet and shit. Like, this one brother told me that I had to stop eating meat and become a vegetarian. Because if we got into a love thing, the juices had to be natural. I told him I'm gonna eat pork chops, hamburgers, anything I please, because I want my juices to have flavor. I ain't think about being no vegetarian, you know? I want somebody to take me shopping so I don't have to buy everything on sale. These shoes are fierce, right? I wear a size 10. These is a 7 narrow. They was the last pair on sale. I had to have them. And the next time out, I want me a real man, okay? Because the man I had before, he didn't do me right. You know, we was living together for a while. 2 weeks. That's a lot of time. Anyhow, you know, I really loved him and everything, you know, because he had a really good job. He was working in the mailroom at this law firm. What y'all laughing at? He was planning on moving up. So anyhow, you know, we were starting to get really close and everything, you know. The commitment was starting to happen. When all of a sudden, he gonna decide he needs space. I hate that space shit, you know. Brothers love to pull that shit. You see these two? They sitting down here together. They must need space. Y'all need space, right? You commitment is starting to happen, they're going to decide they need space. They need time to think. There is space all around you. Everywhere you go is space. And think what you want to think about. Your ass wasn't thinking before. So I moved out. I took all my stuff and left. Well, I didn't take all my stuff. You know, you got to leave some of your stuff so you have a reason to go back. Okay, you know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about, girl, right? And you got to go back looking fine so they can see the mistake they made. Y'all know what I'm saying. You know what I'm talking about, right? So, child, you know, I still had my key and everything, right? So I was gonna go over there and I was gonna be all laid out when he came home, you know. I was gonna have all my little bustier, my G-string, my toes be painted fire engine red, all right? My hair all over the pillow. Toni Braxton on the CD, cause I just want to breathe again. Oh. I love how she do that, you know? Y'all get the picture? Child, I got up in there and some woman's stuff was all over the place. No. Okay? You know what I'm talking about? And you ain't got no hair, so I know you know. All right, girl, I know you know. I'm talking about lipstick, makeup, heels, dresses. The bitch had shit I didn't even have. I took all that stuff and walked her to the incinerator. Okay? I was gonna cut up his stuff, but see, I didn't have a lot of time. So I threw some water in the stereo, I let the birds fly out the window, and I let the cat go for a walk. She's still walking. No, you got to respect me. You know what I'm saying? At least wait a few years before you move some old tired broad in there.
So when I left, I was crying.
You know, y'all got a weird sense of humor.
You know, cause my feelings was, you know, really hurt and everything. So this old nosy woman, I can't stand her. She know everybody's business. She always be hanging stuff out the window. She be hanging out the window. She gonna holler, Shantese! Shantese, honey, what's the matter? I said, me and EZ broke up. Y'all know EZ? I said, me and EZ broke up, and he done moved some old tired woman in there. She said, girl, ain't no woman in there. What you mean ain't no woman in there? I just saw her stuff all over the place. In fact, I threw it in the incinerator. She said, girl, ain't no woman in there. What you mean ain't no woman in there? Ain't no woman in there. He wearing those clothes. I want the sisters to know that the next time they tell you they need space, look in the closet. Ow!
Sometimes I feel discouraged. Thinking all is lost. But then my Savior touches me and leads me on. One thing I never understand. Well, it's a lot of things I don't understand. I work hard to put my 5 children through school. 3 boys and 2 girls. I saw to it that they all went to college and got themselves a good education. For too long, black peoples couldn't go to colleges. I was gonna make sure all of mine went, and that they did. The only one that ever worried me was my baby. Now, of course, he's a full-grown man, but he will always be my baby. He wanted to go off to that school. That school in New York City they call FIT. His dream was to become a famous fashion designer. I told that boy, wasn't no son of mine gonna be no seamstress. Be something strong, I said. A lawyer, a doctor. That's what our peoples need more of. But you know these young folks, they got minds of their own. So finally, I just let them be. If he wants to be a seamstress, I mean a designer. Who am I to stand in his way? Long as he made an honest living for himself, that's what was most important to me. And that he did. Honey, his first year in that school, he made me a fine dress. And I proudly wore it to church on Mother Sunday. All my friends almost liked to tear it off my back. They was whooping and hollering over it. You better get off me. Stop that, child. Then he sent me a newspaper article where they said my baby was an up-and-coming fashion designer. Well, glory be to Jesus. I was so proud of my black baby making a name for herself, I was beside myself with joy. But you know, I started to have funny dreams at night. Dreamt I saw snakes crawling all through my house. They was wrapped all around my house. The next day I got a letter from my baby saying he wasn't gonna be coming home due to some complications. Short while after that, I got another letter from some friends of his saying they was gonna be bringing my baby home cause he wasn't feeling too right. Well, shoot, I didn't worry none. I figured he was up there in New York working himself to death and not eating right. And as soon as he got here, I was gonna make sure he got plenty of rest and lots of his mama's good cooking. I guess y'all wondering what all this got to do with anything. My baby's home now. He's blind. Can't see. His hair's falling out. He don't look nothing like my child what left here. He got this thing they calling. Well, Lord, my baby's dying and there's nothing nobody can do to save him. I hold him in my arms and I read to him from the word, cause I know that nothing's impossible with my God. So I hold on to my faith. And all he keeps saying to me is, Mama, I'm sorry. Oh, but I just rocks him back to sleep. See, I know he done went another way. A way I don't know and probably won't ever understand. But he's my child. And I love him just the same. And I done learned something from this here. Cause you ain't never too old to learn nothing. Don't go looking down upon things you don't understand. Cause you don't know if it's gonna come knocking at your door. Sometimes I feel discouraged. Mama loves you, baby. Thinking all is lost. Then my savior touches me and leaves me. Hello. How's everybody? Look so nice. Really dressed up, huh? Feeling stuck. Don't like your jobs. Want to get out? Afraid to quit? Co-workers talking about you? In the bathroom? The coffee machine, the water fountain, made a fool of yourself at the Christmas party last year, going to make a fool of yourself at the Christmas party this year. Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry. You know, I find it very difficult to keep that kind of thing in. My doctor said it could kill you if you don't let it out. My doctor, he knows, too. A patient blew up in his office once. Just went up, up, up. Feeling stuck. Don't like your look. Tired of your hair. Have no hair. What about your teeth? Can I see everybody's teeth? Dull. Crooked. Beige. Smelly, downright dull, crooked, beige, and smelly. Children run away from you. Come here. Come here. No one sits next to you on the bus. Have an entire subway car to yourself. Wish somebody, anybody, would sexually harass you. Need the answer? Need help? Me too. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Ay. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Ay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Willie Enrique Eduardo Colon. And I don't have a lot of time to play with you because the train is moving very fast. Whoa! Now, what I want from you is some money. Now, I don't have 13 children, so I'm not going to tell you that I need money for the children. Forget it. I don't have nobody. It's just me. And I'm not a rapper, so I'm not going to rap for you. Forget that shit, too. I just don't want to work. Now, I see you all dressed up. You know, you look very nice. You're going to work. That's your thing. It's not my thing. And don't pretend that you're reading nothing. Because when I was standing up over there, I was checking you out. Nobody was reading nothing. As soon as you see me coming, everybody start to read. Forget. And don't give me no penny or no quarter. Because there's a recession going on out there. I can't live off that shit. And I want for everybody to cooperate with me. Because the last time that I do this and the people did not cooperate, I just came back from doing 5 years. And I have a gun. I wasn't going to tell you, but I have a gun. So don't make me nervous. Because the last time when I get nervous, the gun, it shoot my toe. Now, what I want is $5 from everybody here. That's right, $5. And if you don't have it, I suggest you borrow it from the person next to you. And when you get off the train, you can figure out how you're going to pay it back. Okay? So let's go. Mommy. Wow. You heard what she said to me? Come over here, come over here. I like the way she looked. You know, I like when they show her little legs, you know? Look for the money. Mommy, what's your name?
Kedia.
Kedia? Yeah. Oh, forget it. You know, I like a name like that. Kedia! You know, Kedia, I like you, you know? Yeah, I know, it's nice. Something about you make me want to get a job and shit, you know? Ay, 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 mommy. She's flinging her hair and shit, you check it out? So, mommy, I tell you what, you know, I'm going to be waiting over there for you to get off. She's already like this. And I tell you what, when you get off, I'm gonna get off too, okay? She can't wait for that shit. You check her out. All right, where's the money? Come on.
Right here.
Relax. I was just joking. I wanted to see if this shit could really work. You know, I got a fool over there. So now, I'm going to go do it on the number 4 train. For real. Peace. Feliz Navidad. Kedia, I'm going to be waiting for you over there. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Kedia.
be, I can't be, I can't be, I can't be. Hey,
you check that shit out, that shit's fine. How are you doing? Hello. I'm so glad I get to see all you again. Excuse me, I don't talk to nobody without my hat and my glove. Wait. You know the lady I work for, she give me this hat and the glove. Wait, let me ask you something. What you think about this hat? You think red is a good color for me? And honey, she give me the glove. You know, she's a very nice lady. You know, some of these people, you work for them, they don't give you a blasty thing. You know what I mean? You just work, work, work. But she always giving me some little thing. Honey, these gloves is French lace. They come straight from France. What you think? Wait a minute. What is wrong with the blasted glove? Like the glove is a reject. You know you can't trust these damn people. All the work I just do for she, don't think she could give me a decent pair of gloves? Anyhow, I'm not gonna let you upset me. I am doing very, very well. Honey, I tell you, I sent up for my husband, Boise, and my two children, Brenda and Hezekiah. Everybody's in the States now. And I have a couple of good jobs, you know. I am night cleaning down on Wall Street. Then I have a three-day-a-week job babysitting on Park Avenue. After that, I just run down to the East Village to clean a doctor's office. They say running helps you to keep slim. And I don't want you to think I am boasting, but I have my own house now. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, darling. Thank you. And a little used car. Thank you. Why you was looking at me like that? You want to know how I do all this so fast, eh? I just save my money, honey. You ever hear about Susu? Partner. It's like a Christmas club. Every week, 10 of us from the islanders get together and pool our money. I'm not like those girls I work with. Every night they want to buy Chinese food. The Chinaman have that fried rice there since last year. He just keep it in a thing, they call it a wok. You know why they call it a wok? Because they have to wok it up with the soy sauce. Not me, darling. I just bring my food from home. Rice and peas, dumplings, ackee, saltfish. Yes, honey, you know what I'm talking about. Yes. Honey, when you see I eat that food there so I can work straight through for a week. And the next thing those girls I work with like to do, they always want to go on vacation. Where they going? St. Thomas, Barbados. What I want to go to those places for? All you've seen in those places is bush and water. I just leave the bush and water. The hurricane leave plenty of water. I almost get washed. Where in the water? Not me, darling. I'm staying right here because I have big, big plans. I plan on going to night school to learn about real estate. Thank you, darling. Not fake estate, you know, real estate. Honey, let me tell you, I'm gonna buy up the whole of Eastern Parkway in Brooklyn. And I'm gonna call it Millie's Parkway. What do you think about that? Anyhow, I have to go, it's getting late. I have an interview for another part-time job. This one is in a nursing home. But the next time all you see me, honey, I promise you, I'm gonna be at the top, top, top. Because that is where I come here to go. To the top, top, top. Let me hear you say it. To the top, top, top. All it take here, take here. Hello. Hi, I'm back. How's everybody? I'm feeling very vibrant and alive these days. I'm a lot more joyful and centered, too. No more resentments and fears to get in my way. And I tell you, I know now the real meaning of inner peace. That's because I spend time going within. I go within a lot. Thank you.
make a noise, but I think I wore it out. And I just want to say to all of you out there who are going through what I went through, this has made a tremendous difference in my life. For me, it's become like American Express. I don't leave home without it. You know what I mean? Thank you. Thank you very much. You look at it, John. Oh, my goodness. Oh, oh, oh. Slow down. Slow down. Party, come on now. Is it? All right, sure. Yes. Let me hear it now. Oh, honey. I know you like chocolate, darling. Oh, suck it, suck it now. In the house. Oh, yeah. Cut off that music. I got my own song to sing, honey. Wrote it myself. I got a song for y'all. Big is in. Big is in. Forget being thin. Ooh, la, la. Ooh, la, la. Look at Big Mama. Shaking it here. That's for you, honey. Shaking it there. Oh, I got one for you, sugar. Shaking it everywhere. Look at me. Sugar, can you handle what you see? He don't know what to do with all of this, honey. You know, all I ever wanted was to change my luscious 52, 52, 52 into 52, 42, 52. Men love for women nowadays, honey. Yes, indeed. It used to be they only talk to me behind closed doors, you know. After they take their little skinny behind girlfriend home, you know, or their wives, they come knocking on my door. Bertha, Bertha, you in there? That's me, honey. I be in there putting one of my negligees on, or more than likely taking it off. You know something? I got mirrors on all of my walls. I love to see all of me go by. You go, girl. You go. You go. What you want? You know what we want, Bertha, and I just let them in. Lord have mercy. But they getting very public now, child, and they are grabbing me in broad daylight, and I'm loving every fat, delicious minute of it. And I'm gonna tell y'all something. Oh, shucks. The only man I ain't never had is the man I didn't want. And if necessary, honey, I ain't too proud to beg. Oh, baby, please. Oh, look at him. Got his mouth open all wide. He ready. Oh, shucks. Lord have mercy. I see you, honey. I see you. You want to put your hand right here, don't you? Come on. Put your hand in front of me. She ain't gonna do nothing to you, darling. Yes, indeed. Yes, honey. You know, they like to tell you, it's something being big, ain't it? I just love it. You know what I'm saying? They like to tell you when you big, you're not supposed to wear your stripes going this way. Don't they tell y'all that? You're supposed to wear them going this way because it'll make you look bigger. Honey, I wear any damn thing I please. Honey, I got me some spandex dresses. Oh, yeah, sure. Y'all seen me? Ain't nothing like a full-figured woman in spandex. Men be stopping their cars when they see me coming, honey. Have you ever been on the FDR drive and it was backed up? That was me. Cross the street. Keep going, keep going. Keep going. Oh, shut up. And I'm gonna tell y'all something. I'm gonna tell y'all something. I wanna just say it right out, right out, right now. I can't stand skinny broads. I know they're in here. Cause they go everywhere. Have you ever been to a place that wasn't a skinny broad there? Look at her. What you doing in here? And you too. Trying to hide yourself. I see the big sisters. Hello. Awesome. I see y'all in here. I can't stand all y'all skinny broads. Y'all think men like you? Why don't y'all take a vacation at the same time? Find you an earthquake and stand up in the middle of it. Just get the hell on out of here. And I got
got a message for the big girls. Big girls, where you at? Come on, wave your hand. Don't be shy. And if you're on your way to being a big girl, wave your hand. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. I see you. Oh, Lord, honey. Yes, indeed. Make you want to jump, don't it? Make you want to shout. Oh, yes, indeed. We having church up in here. It's the big girl's church. And if it's a skinny girl next to you, really wave your hand. Big girls, listen to this, honey. Oh, look at those teeth. Come on, honey, I want to feed you. Leave that skinny girl. Come on, she ain't giving you nothing. Get over here. Oh, shut. He said he can't. What's she gonna do? What's she gonna do? You ain't gonna do nothing. Get up, move. Get up. Get out your seat. Come here, baby. Come on. Awesome. Kneel down, honey. Kneel down. Put your knee. Get down on your. Oh, no. Lord have mercy. Yes, indeed. Awesome. Whoa, girl. We gonna show them how it's done tonight, ain't we, big girl? Come on, baby. I want you to say, chocolate kiss with a nut in it, honey. Yes! Thank you, baby. Thank you. So, big girls, y'all see how it's done. Y'all see what we got to do. Just take what you want. That's right. Move them skinny girls aside and grab the man. Yes, indeed. And if anybody, anywhere, ever say anything to you about your business, you tell them Bertha Bust Washington said, big is in. Come on, let me hear y'all.
Big is in.
One more time. Big is in. To hell with being fit.
To hell with being fit.
Thank you. I love you, baby. Mwah.
Now listen, girl, I got one for you. You ready for this? Honey, let me tell you what I done did. You ready to hear about this? Honey, I got me 2 new rear view mirrors. Uh-huh, rear view mirrors, child. I put them right outside my window. I use crazy glue to put them out there. Girl, that crazy glue is strong. Them mirrors don't move. Now I can see everything up and down the block and I don't have to turn my head. Ain't that something? I thought of that all by myself. No, 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 listen, let me ask you something, Mabel. What you think about us being African-American this year? Yeah, that's what we calling ourselves now, African-American. Well, girl, it's giving white folks hell to say. Honey, they swallowing their tongues to keep from calling you black. But Mabel, I like being black. Now, you remember when we was Negroes? Honey, they can all go on and be African-American. I'm just gonna be black. Now, Mabel, listen to me, honey. Would you just listen to me a minute? It was your woman's civic duty right to let Imo Jean know that her man was no good. In Lover's Lane that time of night. So, Mabel, could you see real good? The window was all foggy? My Lord. Well, girl, if the window was all foggy, how could you see? You had a dish rag and a flashlight? Girl, I see why you scared, honey. That man is gonna kill you. He's gonna kill you, girl. Uh-huh. Lord have mercy. Girl, now listen, honey, I'm only joking with you. I'm only joking with you, honey. I'm gonna send Bobby over with the baseball bat. Yeah, I got 2 baseball bats. I'm gonna send Bobby over one of them. Mm-hmm. Don't worry your head. But maybe let me ask you something. you be doing in Lover's Lane that time of night? You looking for people's husbands? Oh, Mabel, you's a good friend. No, honey, you's a good friend. Girl, if I had had me a friend like you, I might still have me a husband. Uh-huh. Listen. Don't worry, honey, listen. Let's just change the subject. Can we just change the subject? Don't even worry about that, honey. You know that old Geraldine Tompkins is strung out on crack. Mabel, I can tell a black cracker when I see one. Girl, the first thing that cracker do is eat out black people's hair. And honey, she had her some pretty hair. In fact, she had the kind of hair I got now thanks to Jericurl. What you laughing at, Mabel? Ain't nobody wearing that afro you got. That's how come you can't find you no boyfriend. You just need to do something with your hair. Don't call Shantice, Mabel. Have you seen Shantice's hair lately? Shantice got her nappies up in front and some white woman hanging down the back. Don't call Shantice. The curling iron? What you want to do with the curling iron? Leave Inez and the curling iron alone. Have you seen Inez's face lately? Inez got a scar across her forehead. Down the side of her cheek, straight into her bosom. The curling iron fell out her hand. She trying to cover it up with that old-fashioned fan, but I can see it. Listen, let's just change the subject. Did you see the news last night? Entertainment Tonight. Entertainment Tonight is so the news, Mabel. It's the only news I watch. Honey, white women was on the TV talking about big lips as the style this year. Girl, white women is cutting up their lips and stuffing it with tissue paper. Honey, you know white folks is crazy. They'll cut something off and sew it someplace else if they feel like it. Half of them is walking around with their behinds on their faces. But girl, they had one woman on there, honey, I felt sorry for her. She had an arm problem. Mm-hmm. Like when she would wave at somebody, it'd be this big old piece of fat waving down at the floor. So she went and had this thing they call liposuction. It's like a vacuum cleaner. It'll suck the fat right out. But girl, the doctor made a mistake, honey. Stitched her arm down to the side. Uh-huh. Now she got to wave like this here. Hold on, Mabel, hold on. My other line is ringing. I didn't tell you, I got called waiting. I can make you wait while I talk to somebody else. That's right, so wait. Get on my damn nerves. Hello? Inez, is that you? Girl, don't go nowhere. I got something to tell you. Yeah, I'm talking to Mabel. Nappy-headed Mabel. Uh-huh. Hold on. I'm coming right back. Hold on. All right, Mabel Sugar, I got to go now, honey. Yeah, that's Inez on the other line. Scarface Inez. Yeah, honey. Yes, I'm gonna send Bobby over with the baseball bat. All right, sugar. All right, darling. Okay, honey, I'm gonna talk to you. All right, Mabel. All right, Mabel. All right, Mabel. Damn, that woman don't shut up. Inez, you sitting down? Girl, you ready for this? Listen to this, honey. Mabel saw Imogene's husband in Lover's Lane last night, and he wasn't with Imogene. Lord Jesus, I can't take it anymore. I can't take it anymore, Jesus. They're trying to kill me, Lord. They're trying to kill me, Jesus. All you come back again? You don't have any place to go? I'm doing fine. My husband is gone. He ran away with that big fat woman down the road there. She had big titties out to here. They tell you to keep slim so you can keep him. I run everywhere, trying to keep slim to keep him, and what he do? He run away with that big fat woman down the road there. I guess big is it. And I have pain all over my body. Look how my hand twists up. When all did it first see me, was my hand twist up, sir? No.
I go to the doctor. He say I have arthritis. I am not an artist. I don't write anybody. How the hell I get arthritis? The other day I wake up with a pain from the top of my head straight down to my little toe. I go to the hospital, Kings County. Don't go there. They wouldn't even give me an aspirin. They want to know if I have insurance. A poor man was sitting there, blood running from the top of his head straight into his mouth. And all he keeps saying is, Lover's Lane. He wasn't in Lover's Lane. It's like a hurricane come and hit my life. And I have so many bills to pay. Bills, bills, bills. And for what? My husband gone. The children is big men and women now. They don't have uses for me again. I think I should retire while I can still walk. But I must say one thing. God bless America. Yes, I'm gonna say it, man. All you see what does happen around the world when the people try to speak out and the government kill them? In America, I can't say any damn thing I please. I can't tell Mr. Bush, you was no damn good, I'm glad you're gone. So I say, God bless America. But I'm thinking about heading back home, man. This going to the top, top, top is killing me. I rent in my 3 houses. I sell a little used car. I already buy myself a ticket. I am going home. No, it's all right, it's all right. All you need to come go with me, because when I look at all you, all they look like they're killing you here. You need a little vacation. So if you ever decide to come down to my island for a little vacation, ask anybody in the village for me, Miss Millie. I've been in a big, big hotel by the bush near the water. I'm gonna see all you. All you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Don't know why, well, well, ain't no sun up in the sky. Stormy weather, since that gal and I ain't together. I don't know where she's gone.
Anybody seen that gal? Y'all seen that gal? That Lena Horne with something else. How y'all doing?
Right.
I said, how you doing?
Right.
You look like you're doing all right. There's a lot of things going on in your world. I've been listening to it all night. Whoa. Who's that? There go that Miss Shantese. That girl is always flinging that hair like it's hers. Walk around like her shoe too tight. Shantese! What's the matter with your foot, honey? Accident happened on the block today. Jerry Curl and Peeping Tom Gossip fell out the window. She tried to hold on to the rearview mirror, but the crazy glue didn't work. She went right on down to the bottom. What a mighty God we serve. God don't like ugly. There was a nice young fella. He used to live up the road from here. Liked to make dresses all the time. I never did understand that. Anyhow, he done went home. He wasn't feeling too good. But you know, every Tuesday night at prayer meeting, we's a praying for him to come through. 'Cause God is greater than all these diseases. Don't you believe that? But that young fella followed his dream. What about y'all here tonight? You following your dream? 'Cause when you get to be my age, you can feel dreams in the room. Some of y'all are scared. You're scared you won't make it. Some of y'all done gave up on your dreams. And I hear you talking all the time to your friends about your problems. Stop all that talking to your friends about your problems. Half of them don't care. The other half glad it's you. Tell your problems to Jesus. That's right, I said Jesus. Hazel told me don't come out here talking about no Jesus, but I'm gonna say it anyway. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus been mighty good to me. You got somebody else been good to you? Say that name. That'll help you hold on to your dreams. That'll help you go for it. Because that dream is the thing that might save you. Yeah, I'm preaching now. Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
Like that gal Hazel. She been dreaming about going to Broadway. I said, well, go on then. Broadway about 10 minutes away from here. What you doing over here? So I want you to hold on to your dreams. Take one step at a time. Ask for help. And always remember to let your light shine. Because this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Y'all know that song? I said, do you know that song?
Yeah.
Well, come on, sing it with me. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Whoa. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.